Hello all, welcome back to the Interventionist channel. I hope you all had a wonderful holiday time. Sorry for the long delay between the last video and the current one. I was tied up with family and personal matters. So this is a comeback video. So I will be doing a short session on a physics set. Few of the subscribers have asked about a doubt about T2 versus stereo imaging, so I'll be covering that aspect today in this video. So today's video we'll be discussing about stereo versus flat side images in a short brief PowerPoint presentation, followed up by the case review. So be patient and do watch the entire video. So what about fat sat? Fat sat, actually it's a broad terminology. Fat suppression is the broad terminology. Fat suppression sequences are quite a few number of fat suppression sequences are there in routine MR. In general, the most common ones which we use are FS images, which is correctly called as fat saturated sequences. So it can be T1 FS or T2 FS. And there are other modalities of fat suppression techniques are there, which involve chemical shift based studies, T1 relaxation time based studies, and there are other studies as well. So this is a flowchart which I obtained from one of the slides. I thank the author for putting up a very good slide in that. So fat suppression techniques is chemical shift based one, or T1 relaxation time based one, or hybrid based one. So chemical shift based studies are basically, these are the physics behind different modality of studies. One is chemical pre-saturation, selective excitation, and Dixon method. So what in chemical pre-saturation, what we does is we do saturation even in the microscopic level to suppress fat. This one is especially used in the in-phase and out-phase imaging of your adrenal glands. The selective excitation involves the selective excitation of fat molecules and non-fat molecules. Dixon technique is another set of physics which you have to learn. And the T1 relaxation time is stereo-based studies, that is IR study, which is stereo. And hybrid studies involve studies like SPIR and SPIR. So other than stereo and FS images, we will not be discussing much in this study today. So what is stereo? STIR stands for short tau inversion recovery, which is essentially an inversion recovery sequence. It can be considered as the exact opposite of your flare study, that is fluid attenuation inversion recovery, where the fat is suppressed. Here in fluid attenuation inversion recovery sequences, the fluid is suppressed, whereas in STIR we are suppressing the fat. So that is the principle. So basically what we do is we are using inversion recovery pulses, that is 180 degree rephasing pulses, to phase out the fat molecule signals from the imaging. So what happens is that the fat which has short T1 and T2 relaxation time will get nullified, and it will appear dark on the stereo images. Only the tissues with longer T1 and T2 times, like water, ECF, inflammatory tissue, non-fibrotic masses, will appear bright on stereo images. The thing to note here is, well, the reason I mentioned non-fibrotic masses is, non-fibrotic mass will have high stereo signal, but in cases of fibrosis, even in stereo, the signal will be dark. So just remember that. So now coming to T1 FS and T2 FS image, which is actually the part of the discussion today. T1 FS stands for T1 fat saturated images, and T2 fat saturated images. So as the name suggests, we are using a secondary technique where we are using adequate saturation bandages, saturation bands, that is called fat suppression bands, in that routine T1 and T2 imaging. Usually we use it with spin echo imaging, which will be represented as T1 FS and T2 FS alone. But if you are clubbing it with other faster acquiring modalities like turbo spin echo and fast spin echo imaging, it has to be clubbed like that. It will come as FSE or TSE like that. So it is an extrinsic application of saturation bands through coils applied over the body. We are applying pulses to phase out the saturate the fat molecules. Okay, so it is very useful in post contrast IV Gadolinium imaging, and in most routine conventional MRI imaging, where we use FS images routinely as T1 FS pre and T1 FS post contrast images. So the fat containing tissue signal is always suppressed. So only disadvantage of T1 FS and T2 FS images is that the suppression of fat will not be homogeneous as in STIR. So you need all modalities in a combined way to assess a MRI case. So remember that. So hello. So when you compare, I just put these sections to show you how different imaging modalities look. This is actually a STIR coronal image. I'm trying to load another pre-contrast T1 FS image, and this is a normal T2 sagittal image. So what are the basic differences when you look into it? So the most important thing you look here is you will see suppression of the fat. So somebody has asked me about what is FatSat. So FatSat is any sequence which you essentially use to suppress the fat. So it can be T1, it can be T2, it can be any other particular sequence. Okay, so that is there are a lot of ways to suppress the fat. So one such sequence where we use fat suppression is called STIR. STIR is a default T2 sequence where we are using inversion recovery technique to suppress the superficial fat or deep fat or any fat at all. So basically we are suppressing the entire fat. So how we do that? We are using inversion recovery pulses. So at a certain frequency intervals, and we are phasing out the fat signals, and we are only imaging the water molecules. So STIR stands for short tau inversion recovery sequence. Similarly, in a FatSat image, what you can see here is actually you can see certain bright bands. These are the areas where the suppression was not complete. But meanwhile, in STIR image, the suppression is somewhat complete. So generally, when we do a T2 image, we will do a T2 STIR and not T2 FS. STIR, because STIR will have much more uniform fat suppression compared to a T2 FS image, given the size, axis, and position of the study. Similarly, if you consider T2 FS and STIR, the FS image will have much more anatomic clarity, because basically those are spin echo sequences with fat suppression. But the uniformity of suppression will depend upon so many things. The way you apply the saturation bands, the way the saturation bands work correctly. In some machines, due to some technical issues, the suppression bands won't work very clearly, as you can see in this particular case here. So that is one problem. Meanwhile, in STIR, you can get a homogeneous suppression of the entire fat. So generally, as a dictum, STIR imaging is quite useful when you are using imaging of periphery. For example, you are imaging skeletal system, you are imaging muscle MSK, you are imaging neck and all. It is very good. It's like STIR is exactly opposite of FLIR. You can imagine like that. Basically, in STIR, it's like the T2 image where fat is suppressed, and FLIR is the T2 image. It can be taken in T2 or T1. If it is T2 FLIR, it's an image where the fluid is suppressed. So don't get confused. STIR is for fat suppression, FLIR is for fluid suppression. So that is the basic thing. So hope I have covered the doubt for you. Thank you. Do continue subscribing. We are on the road to 1K. We have to reach that landmark. Once we reach that landmark, I promise you to reward you with a new set of quiz.